Everybody, welcome back. Billy, Gem City Welding, glad to have you. Today's episode is going to be how to extend upper Impala A-Arms. This would be 58 to 64. Pretty straightforward. I think you're going to love the video. Very similar to doing the frame. So if you've been keeping up to speed on the frame process, pretty much the same deal. Just mark plates, cut plates, tack them on, whack them with a hammer, and weld them, and you're done. Right. But anyways, so stay tuned, and we'll have that up for you. Okay, everyone. So what we got here is got my stock control arm, upper control arm. Got my templates, and then I've got my completed driver side arm. Pretty straightforward process, like I was just talking about with the frame. Basically taking something like this that is, you know, straight off the car, haven't done a single thing to it but unbolt it. These are factory riveted ball joints, and I don't know if they still do that on modern cars, but I know, you know, like my Malibu all the way up into the 80s, they still had riveted on ball joints. So basically we got to grind the head off of the rivets and then punch those through, and then this whole entire ball joint can be separated from the A-arm. And then we'll want to take a wire wheel. Let's see, I got one here. Something kind of like this. It doesn't have to be the style. It can be the twisted kind, you know, anything works. Or if you got access to a sandblaster, throw that bad boy in a sandblaster. And then from there, you're just gonna clean it up and you're gonna make your templates. So what I have here, this is what I will call the top plate. So that goes on that guy just like that. And of course, you know, everybody, this is pretty self-explanatory, guys. It's not rocket science. I've noted here, you gotta make two of these, and these go like that. Pretty straightforward. And then this is an inner reinforcement, and I'll show you a little bit of that on my completed one. So in case everyone's wondering, these are 1 inch extended. Yeah, 1 inch extended. And I chose to do that because, well, for one, I like the looks, but two, they're, you know, if you believe the theories that everybody talks about with these kind of things, the science behind them, there is some benefits to having an offset ball joint. When it comes to hopping a car, not that that's going to happen here. But yeah, so I went with a 1 inch extension, and I'll show you the side profile of that. Focus, babe, focus. There we go. So basically the 1 inch extension occurred right here at the ear. Alex from Hoppos has a great tutorial on how to do this for a gbody. Control arm, but essentially you mark it here, then you cut down this way, and you put the extension there. You know, the old school way of doing it, and guys probably still do it this way, is you used to cut the arm right down the center and put in your extension there. I like the way, you know, Alex does it, a lot of guys do it at the ear, because I feel like it makes it a lot simpler to do that. And so essentially what you're doing is you're reinforcing the whole outside of this, okay, and then wraps around the front. You can see I've reinforced this area here, which is where I made the extension. So I've completely covered that portion of the extension with a reinforcement plate. Some folks will go all the way to the ear and around here. I still have the option to do that. I didn't do that on this one. You know, I made down the road sometime, decide to do that. But the idea is, it's pretty simple, guys. And of course, you know, you gotta, where the top plate mounts, you gotta weld that as well. Let's see. Yeah, so 1 inch extension. Oh, and it's been updated for a GM metric ball joint. So the stock Impala would have had a bolt hole here, somewhere like right around in here and here. So those will be completely welded shut to the bottom side of this plate. And then of course I've already drilled the holes for the new GM metric unbreakable ball joint, which, let's be honest, every ball joint's gonna break. It's just a matter of time and, you know, pressure that you put on the ball joint. I'm keeping these stock. Some guys will cut these and do like the U-shaped or the C-shaped. I'm not a big fan of that. There's nothing wrong with that. It's just not the look that I'm going for. And of course I have new bushings for the dog bones here, which I think that's what most guys refer to them as. So yeah, not too much going on there, guys. Super simple. And like I said, if you've been watching the frame videos and you're up to speed on that, it's a very, very similar process. Just take your time, don't be in a hurry. Double, triple check your measurement, especially when you go to cut the arm. That, you know, if you're doing a 1 inch, you wanna make sure it's 1 inch. And even though my material that I'm using, that's a 1 inch strip of 3/16. Sorry, focus. Anyways, you get the idea. Maybe. Whatever. 1 inch piece. You're gonna have, you know, if you've seen the welding video on the end of one of my frame wrap video, the very last one of that, you're gonna leave a little bit of space to get your penetration for your weld in there. So yeah, I've got 1 inch material, but if I leave, you know, an eighth to a quarter on each side, you know, I can end up with a 1 1/4 inch extension or, you know, whatever. So just keep that in mind. Give yourself a little bit of room unless you're doing you're fully gonna butt them together, which if you're doing a lay and play car, you'd probably be okay. But if you're, you know, really not sure, just give yourself a little bit of a gap and get that penetration in there. So that's what we gotta do. I've already marked my steel plate, my 3/16. Actually I gotta mark these. Oh no, I already did that. Back on it. So I got those two there, top plate and the side pieces. This is my last plate of 3/16, so I'm gonna have to get some more when I go to do the lowers, when I plate those. So hopefully be here pretty soon. But of course, like I've said in previous videos, this is winter time for me. So it's a lot of this is hit or miss just because of my job. But I'm gonna try and get it knocked out. And I really would like to get started on getting this stripped down. Get the block stripped down, get all the paint off of it, clean everything up as best as I can. I did get a new clutch fan. I think I talked about that maybe in one of the other videos. If not, surprise, there it is. Because this guy, I've got the rear lowers in. You guys saw me make those. Of course, you know, my pit bull rear end, so I've got to get that assembled. A very good friend of mine is coming through with me on the other bracket that goes to here. So I've got that on the way, and then I can do the mock-up of the rear end. But it's getting to a point to where I'm gonna have to start doing a full-scale mock-up of everything and then start addressing paint needs, because I've come to the conclusion that I'm gonna paint this frame. I am not going to powder coat it, even though I love a powder coated finish. If I chip this thing on the road, I don't want to have any issues with powder coating. And I've been told that water can get behind the chip and chip off powder coating. So I don't want a problem. Plus, if I'm out at a show or if I'm just here in the garage and stuff, if I want to touch it up, I can just and be done with it. So that's where I'm going with that. But I'm getting to a point where I'm gonna have to start doing some assembly to make sure this stuff's gonna mock up before I start breaking everything down for paint. Probably do that after I get the front lowers done and the spindles. Cause I'm looking at this stuff right now, guys. I'm trying to remember. Yeah, I got the spindles I gotta do and those lowers. and I can start, you know, bolting them in here. And oh, I gotta cut cylinder holes, so that'll be coming soon. And going from there. So that's pretty much it for right now. I'm going to set you guys up, get these cut out, and gotta get that ball joint out of there and start cleaning up that.
Hang tight, so we'll be back soon. All right, guys, didn't do a time lapse on cutting of the plates just because I did so much of that stuff when I was working on the frame. So yeah, I just cut everything out,
show you what I got. That's pretty much A-arm reinforcing 101 cutting plates. Super simple, just like the frame video, guys. Again, this plasma cutter thing, if you guys don't have one, get one. They're getting to the point to where they're practically giving them away. And
ultimately, guys, make the investment in yourself. Get the tool, do the job you need, save yourself the money, and make it happen. You know what I mean? But for right now, this is pretty much where I'm gonna leave it.
I've gotta actually go get ready and head down to the Cincinnati Autorama Cavalcade of Customs. You guys will probably see the video of that before this one, just because of the timing, and I don't really want to rush this process of getting the stuff done.
But getting ready to head down there to hang out with the Dedication Car Club and the Club Brothers. I don't get to see very much. Every chance I get, I try to go down and hang out with them. Still getting to know them, but pretty good group of guys, and really looking forward to that. And hopefully it should be a good car show. So if you haven't watched that video yet, please go back. It's probably gonna be the one right before this one. So take a look at that, and I hope you enjoy it. So I'll bring you back next time, probably be in a few days, and I'll finish out the video, and we'll get the stuff done. So I'll see you then. Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. It's been a couple days since my last update on this video here. Just went through Cavalcade. Wow, what an awesome time. I'm sure by now you've probably seen the Cavalcade video. Again, I wanted to thank everyone who's stopped me at the show and told me they watched the videos, and I was surprised to how many people actually did that. Pretty cool to get to talk to people in person, and you know, when somebody comes up and says, hey, I learned to do this from you, or I learned to do this from you, that just, you know, makes me want to keep doing this even more. So again, thanks to everybody that stopped me at the show. Just getting some plates cleaned up here. I've got all my parts laid out for this control arm here, which I still have to do the ball joint for that, removal of that. But the idea is, it's pretty similar to the frame plates. You want to get these as clean as you can on the edges for when you go to weld. If you're using a plasma, guys, make sure you're getting all that scale off that's left over from the plasma cutting. This actually is called mill scale. This gray you see, you can weld over it, okay? Some guys will grind that completely off. You know, in the welding industry, welding world, I hear it all the time. It's two different ways. You can do it, or you can't, or you don't have to. But anyways, that's mill scale from the mill. Just kind of hit the edge, clean that edge up a little bit, and then if you choose to take it off in the end, you know, more power to you. Go for it. But that's what I'm working on today. I don't know how far I'm going to get on this segment, just because my son's got basketball tonight, and it's just another go week for us. But it's really warm outside, which is really unusual for this time of year in Ohio. So I'm going to get as far as I can today on working on these, and we'll just keep the series going. So hang tight, I'll be back. Well, that only took an eternity. Had to grind the rivets, the heads off the rivets. Now I'm gonna grind those down completely flush and punch them through and get some of this grease and grime and all this stuff off the backside. All right, got them out. I gotta remind myself to put the 2 hour later meme in here somewhere. Now, time to clean them up. Here we go. All right, so I'm in the middle of cleaning up the arm, trying to wire wheel it the best I can. I don't have a sandblaster at home, but this seems to do okay. It did okay on the other arm. I still gotta do the backside, but long story short, I'm working on this arm and my son says, Dad, you got a package in the mail, come get it. So, go out to get the package and here we are. First one for the channel. This is from my good friend Max. He owns The Chop, Metalworks and Fabrication in Defiance, Ohio. So Max, shout out to you, buddy. This is pretty important for me for the car. I put out a post not too long ago looking for a certain part for the 64, and Max reached out to me and he says, bro, I got you. I got this. So we're gonna open it together. Yeah. That's it. That's it right there, ladies and gentlemen. Max, you're my hero, dude. Thank you so much for helping a guy out with this. So now I have both for the Pitbull Wishbone, because this uses a 58 style dual mount. I think they switched back to dual mounts in 65, but the important thing here is that I have this now for the driver's side. So this will allow me to complete the mock-up of the Pitbull rear end and the frame. First package for the channels, you know, somebody helping me out. So Max, I'm grateful for you, brother. Thank you so much. And yeah, this is great. So back at it, I'm gonna finish cleaning up the arm, and depending on the weather, it's snowing right now. I'm just waiting on that phone call to go into work. So I'm gonna see what I can get done today and bring you back when I got some more progress. Stay tuned. All right, everybody, we're back. It's been a couple days since the last little portion of the video you just watched. Snow here in Ohio, I've already told you before, it's just how it is. But long story short, I got the cross shaft out, got the bushings removed. Guys, if you have to take out bushings, grab you an air hammer if you have one, to an air compressor, or a chisel and a punch and a hammer, just a handheld hammer. And really all you have to do on Impala arms, and I'm sure there's other arms that are very similar to this, the bushing will sit right on this ring. Basically all you have to do is come in from this side. Couple light taps with the hammer, with the air hammer if you have one available, or a chisel and a punch, and just a regular handheld hammer. And that should usually push those out. In the rare case that you have to heat them up with a torch or a map gas or something like that. But they should probably just come right out, especially if they're this old and they're just wore out. So back in the garage, back in here today, so this is just kind of cleaned up just how I was talking in the previous segment that you seen. It's not the cleanest in the world because I don't have a sandblaster. But the process is the same. You know, you just get them as clean as you can. Use your wire wheel. I use these twisted ones. I like those the best. But these right here will also work well too. So just keep that in mind. But the process is really, really simple, okay? So let me put you on a tripod here and then I'll bring you back in a second and get everything marked out. Okay, so the next step in this process, after you get these cleaned up to where you would like to have them, just grab you a Sharpie, be any color you want, as long as you can see it on the arm itself. A lot of guys will trim this lip off all the way around. All the way through here. And then some guys will leave that and just butt their plate, the side reinforcement plate, right up to that lip. I'm actually gonna take the lip off because I did my other arm that way, but it's super simple, guys. You just start on the edge and work yourself all the way around. Give yourself a nice reference line. I hope that's showing up. Same on this side, just a nice reference line. That way you know where you're cutting at. Of course, you can use soapstone. Soapstone might be a little bit better when it comes to the plasma, just because, you know, Sharpie can be kind of dark to see. But that's really it. We're just gonna trim this lip off, come back in and completely grind this face, this whole entire face, and make it completely smooth all the way around. That'll give us a good place to get our plate, a reinforcement plate on the side, and we'll get that nice, and it will make it nice and tight to this side of the arm so we can completely weld that whole entire joint. So, I'm gonna set you up on time lapse, get the plasma hooked up, get the air compressor hooked up, and we'll be back. So, hang tight. So, you guys saw time lapse, just trim that edge off. The point here is to just get a nice, clean, crisp edge on your arm. So when you go to place the plate that you've already cut, you'll be able to get everything to fit. Of course, I have to shape it still, but you get the idea. Everything's gonna fit nice and tight. Once I get everything all bent and perfectly in the shape. But super simple, guys. And then, of course, during the time lapse, you see me run a grinder in on this leading edge. You just want to make sure you clean up any of that slag from where you used your plasma. Do you have to have a plasma cutter to do this? No, you do not. You can use a fiber wheel, cutoff wheel, if you have to. But I'm not using much of those these days, but actually you're gonna already see me use one, so spoke a little too soon. But so now what we'll do is we'll actually get this marked up, and the best way to do this, Alex has turned a lot of people onto this, and it's nothing new. It's been happening for a long time, but it makes life a lot easier when it comes to doing these kinds of arms. Because like I said earlier in the video, guys will cut them right down the middle. Some guys still do that. If that's what you do, that's your thing. It's cool. It's no big deal. It's not, you know, there's many different ways to do this, but the method that Alex uses, a lot of guys uses, is pretty straightforward, pretty self-explanatory. So let me bring you in and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So, tight. All right, peeps, here we go. Really, really simple. Focus, there we go. So basically we're trying to get the flattest part of the arm, and we're trying to follow that curve a little bit, how it goes to the back of the arm. And basically all I did was just lay this right on that and mark a straight edge. That will be where I'll add my 1-inch extension. And then of course, this line here, this portion of the arm will slide back the 1-inch. So you will have a little bit of overhang right here. But when you go to do your top plate, you'll be able to bend all that in together, blend it all in together, and it'll pretty much be seamless. Same with the other side. Not much different. Just try to mark it as straight as you possibly can, and then follow that. Can see that curve. Follow that curve all the way around. So now what I'm actually gonna do is I'm actually going to use a flap disc to cut these. My plasma could cut it, probably damn near perfect, but I want the reliability of having a flap disc on this, or I'm sorry, a cutoff wheel on this fiber wheel, and just get that nice crisp straight line. So let's see, I'm gonna, oh, something else we gotta consider too. Flip around and show you. When you go to cut these ears, okay, you've got obviously your right and your left, okay? When you go to cut these independently from one another, you know, it might be difficult to get that to realign just perfect with the other side. So a really simple remedy for that is to take a piece of angle iron. In this case, I've actually made one out of just some stock I had laying around. But the idea is to take a piece of angle iron, if you have it, lay it on your arm and tack it. That way, sorry, this is out of focus, guys. That way, when you go to cut both of the ears, they will remain in place and not twist from one another. So that way everything will stay nice and square. It'll make it a lot easier to line things up and just take a lot of the guesswork out of it. So I'm going to set you back up, change over to cutoff wheel, and get to cutting. Be back. So here we are. Got our full 1-inch extension. Got both the arms fairly close. Keep in mind, this one's been plated. Obviously this one has not. So, you know, this thickness out to here is gonna be a little bit different just because I don't have those 3/16 plates on yet. But that was just trying to show you, you know, how close they are, once they are locked up. There it is, guys. There's your one inch extension. Excuse me. It's not the prettiest in this stage, okay? See the fitment there? Of course, the fitment there. Now, you can see a gap between the plates, okay? I've done that, so I left myself plenty of room to get that wire in there to get penetration, okay? And, you know, I've talked about in the previous welding videos and stuff with the frame about leaving yourself just a little bit of space to get that penetration in there. It's not a true butt joint, okay? I've left, like I said, just a little bit of room. And yes, that, you know, let's say it's an 1/8 inch on each side of that 1-inch extension. So we're looking at, you know, 1/4 inch. It's 1 1/4 inches. It's not, yeah, I have a 1-inch piece, but I've left myself enough room. Now, I don't think those openings are 1/8 inch. They might be 1/16. So let's call it 1 1/8 inches. The point I'm trying to make is leave yourself the room, get the penetration in there. I'll weld these up and I'll show you that here in just a few moments. But, you know, if somebody wants to argue with you about, oh, that's not a true 1-inch, just tell them to look closer at it. And when they do, you smash their head into the A-arm, because where's their A-arms, right? You made your own, that's what you're working with. So I'm just kidding, don't smash anybody's heads in A-arms. I'm just playing around. But that's pretty much it. That's pretty much the gist of it. Now, you saw me in the time lapse where I had the arm like this. Just look at this guy. Oh my gosh, those are so much heavier once it's plated. You saw me take this top plate. Now, if you remember, I told you there would be a little bit of an extension, right, that you would have to cover. So your template needs to take that into consideration. Okay? When you go to plate these,
There you go. You get the idea. Okay, that's gonna cover that whole joint. And then of course, same on this side. Sorry, I'm just holding this one-handed, but you get the idea, okay? So your patterns need to be able to match that 1-inch extension. And I made my pattern after I had already cut this arm, or I'm sorry, the first arm initially. That way I knew what the 1-inch was gonna look like, how it was gonna be. But you know, you'll come in here, you'll weld this, you weld this whole entire seam, and then flip it upside down and do the same exact thing on the inside. And of course, remember, this whole thing gets reinforced, gets plated. And then very similar to what I, well, it's not very similar at all. It's actually the exact same thing. Remember, I went over the 1-inch extension portion with a reinforcement plate on the inside. So, I mean, these things are double, triple plated, you know what I mean? And that weld joint is gonna be completely encased with weld and plate by the time it's all said and done with it. So, the next step in this process is for me to actually weld up those weld joints. I'm not gonna make it tonight on doing that. It's already, well, it's almost my bedtime, so I'm gonna have to save this part for tomorrow, but that'll be another day and I'll be ready to rock. So it's gonna be just a second for you, but a whole night for me. So I will see you tomorrow. Take care. All right, welcome back. It's a new day, sun's shining, snow's melting. Let's get at it. I'm gonna flip you around and let's weld up some A-arms. Okay, so what the takeaway from this is, by giving ourselves the small little gap like I talked about in the previous segment, we've been able to get penetration on the back side. So hopefully this will show up. There you go, guys. That's my weld bead from the front side of the arm. Sorry, there we go. So that's fully penetrated through. And then of course I'm gonna weld the back side. But having this gap and having that beveled edge
is really the secret when it comes to the strength portion of this whole entire thing. You know, if a guy was doing a lay and play setup and just wanted to do a 1-inch extension and he's not hopping the car, he's not, you know, going crazy doing dumb stuff like I'm gonna be doing. But anyways, a guy could grind that and probably just roll it and be fine. Of course, I'm plating everything because, you know, I just want the security, the added strength and reliability. So it's that simple and not much to it. So I'm gonna keep on welding. You guys see me, usually I'll trim the tip of this off every time before I weld. That's just a habit of mine, but the instructor got me doing that back when I was going to school at Hobart, because what's happening is you'll build up that little ball on the edge of the weld wire, and then it's sometimes the arc can have trouble starting. So for 100% smooth arc every time, just trim that little piece off if you want. All right, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. It's the insides. Pretty straightforward. Now, of course, you can come back and grind all that down if you want to. I'm probably gonna leave the inside that way and just plate over it like I did the other arm. Of course, this side, I'm gonna blend completely and then reinforce this whole edge and then the top, just like the first arm that I did. So, pretty straightforward. It's a lot like the frame. But yeah, not too difficult. So set you up on a time lapse. do some grinding. Guys, sorry, like a dope, I didn't record. I thought I was recording and I wasn't. Sorry about that. This process is, like I was telling you earlier, very similar to the frame wrap, reinforcement process. So all I've done is I've already, you know, pre-cut my side plates, and I just shaped those to the A-arm and then got those tacked in place. So now comes the fun part. I'm just going to weld this entire seam all the way around the front, on the underneath side, this lip. I'm gonna weld this whole entire seam, and then I'll be able to grind that smooth, you know, mold that shape in preparation for the top plate that goes on here. So again, not a whole lot to see, nothing really earth, you know, groundbreaking, earth shattering, but that's just part of the process. So going back to time lapse, I'm gonna weld this up and get to grinding. So hang tight. Okay, so that's the top side, fully welded. These are solid passes, not tacks. Let's see. You get the idea. That can all be molded, ground smooth. So now what I'll do is I'll flip it to the bottom side, start welding up all these joints here on the bottom side before we start to plate the top. So let me get you set back up and do some more welding. Hang tight. Something I just realized about welding these up, or pretty much anything with welding that you're going to be doing that's has long, consistent, continuous passes, jump around on the part. Try not to go in a solid straight line the whole entire way. You know, small sections if you can, keep from distortion, twisting things. You know, the heat, it doesn't take much, and next thing you know, you got a pretzel on your hands. So just keep that in mind. So I'll flip you around and show you the inside. Okay, so that's the inside of that, all the way around, and then all the way back around the other side. Now those are long passes, but you can see my tacks. I did jump around quite a bit, okay? And then of course reinforced the tie-in in the front of the A-arm. You'll note this is still drilled for the Impala ball joint. I'm going to do that once I do the, I'll re-drill it for the Napa unbreakables when I do the top plate. But something to take notice, you know, I have my top pass here on the outside. If you look in down in that, down at the bottom, right there, you can see where it was biting into the arm. Okay, nice penetration on the arm. Sorry, the heat's throwing the camera off a little bit. But anyways,
You get the idea. Pretty self-explanatory. This is still a little long. You know, I made them a little bit wider so I could sneak up on the weld and trim back what I don't need at the end. But that's just the fabricator in me trying to give myself some wiggle room. So you get the idea. So now I think I'll probably smooth out those welds. And no, I take that back. I'm gonna put the inside plates on to reinforce the ears where I had to do the extension portion. So I'll get you back set up and I'll start putting those in. You can make doing stuff like this. This thing was clean when I started the other day, but whatever. So here you go, guys. The 1-inch extension is completely encapsulated between those two plates. Solid welded all the way around. And of course, that side is the same exact thing. Okay. Solid passes. But pretty good shape. And of course, like I said, I left extra so I can trim back what I don't need. So just something to keep in mind. I'm gonna get this set up and grind the top like we were talking before. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so it would appear as though it's not that I'm not recording, but my battery was dying. So I lost some footage, so I'm so sorry about that. But again, same process like the frame. This is what I was recording and wasn't able to get. So pretty simple stuff. Just running that top plate, trying to get those gaps nice and tight. That way I can get a nice weld seam on the upper plate. I've had to smooth this out because I didn't show this on the first one because I didn't record the first one, but now that you're seeing it, to get this dish, you know, a couple wax with a hammer and get that profile. Some guys might bend that. I really don't know, to be honest with you. It's the first set I've ever made, but couple wax with a hammer, get that plate to come up like this, and then just clean everything up with a flat disc. Of course, you see there's no holes yet. I haven't got that far. I don't like doing the holes first, at least at this point I don't, because I don't know 100% that I can get that lined up correctly the first time. There may be
some kind of like cheat mode that I don't know about to do these, but I'm just winging this set. First set ever done. Turned out pretty good so far. So I'm gonna set you up now that I have a charged phone and do a time lapse and get some welding done. So here we go.
Hey, what up, guys? Welcome back. Total disclosure, this video is an absolute jumbled mess. This video is about 4 weeks in the making, believe it or not. And most of that is just because it's winter time and I have to stop working snow shifts, salting, plowing, doing all that stuff.
It's all I can do to be out here this time of year. So today hopefully is the last day for the uppers. I'm gonna flip you guys around and show you what I got and go over a couple things, and then I'm gonna cut you loose. So hang tight. Okay, so here we are. Got both the upper passenger, upper driver. Got everything drilled out. The last little clip you guys were watching, I don't know what you want to call it, not slow motion, but where it's sped up. This was the arm I was working on. I was just trying to grind everything, make everything nice and smooth and uniform. Grind out where I had to whack that with a hammer a couple times, just to get that to form to the shape I want. But you get the idea. Again, these are cut. I cut these holes out after the fact. I use my plasma to do that. There are probably guys who are slick enough with this kind of stuff landed out that they can get it the first time. I am not one of them. But one of the things I wanted to go over, let me grab a glove here because this one's still kind of hot, is, okay, so you see I got the G-body bolt pattern, okay? It's four bolts. The stock Impala would have been one here, here, and here. By going to the G-body, we have to, of course, re-drill it. And the idea is that you want to plug weld the original Impala location where the holes would have been. That just welds the arm to the face plate that you used for your reinforcement. You get the idea. This is not a hard project, guys. Just, it takes time. It takes patience. You want to lay out everything the best you can. You know, fitment is everything. Getting those plates to fit nice and tight. Let me flip this one over. It might still be warm too. Of course, I haven't welded this one yet. I was in the middle of welding this one and I said, oh, I better stop and talk to everybody about this. But yeah, so you would want to weld up, that hole, and it's down in there, that hole. Again, fitment is key. Clean these up really good. Of course, you know, yeah, a little dirty, but it's not stopping me from doing what I need to do. Don't get your dog bones mixed up. Don't get those backwards. Try to mark them somehow the best you can. And then also, you want to weld You want to weld that lip all the way around. And get those backwards. Mark them. Awesome. Good. I had actually stamped the top of the arm somewhere in this area before I plated them, driver and passenger, with an actual metal stamp. That way I couldn't get them mixed up. There's another way to tell. I'll start with the driver. Driver side on Impalas, got this little curve in the front. Passenger would be the opposite direction. This is towards the front of the car, like the motor would be here. There's the arm, you know. So you get the idea. But just remember, they got this pretty distinguishing mark. I'm not sure if other makes or models have those. Your G-body or Caddies or your Lincolns. You know, guys convert Lincolns over to like Cadillac A-Arms and stuff like that. That would actually be a question for Cadillac Dan. But anyways, you get the idea. Again, jumbled mess of a video. Thank you so much for sticking with me. It's gonna be a rough edit, but it's just the best I can do for this time of year. We actually got like really unusually warm weather now all of a sudden, and it's probably gonna rain like hell for a couple days, but whatever, at least it's above freezing. So I'm gonna take it and get some stuff done. So thank you for like, sharing, and subscribing, and being through this with me. And just something to touch on real quick, the previous video before this was the lowrider history giveaway video. there's still a few spots open for that giveaway. So if you haven't done that, all you have to do is be a subscriber and type in video comment giveaway on that specific video, okay? Once I hit that magic 50 mark, we'll do a drawing and I'll get that out to a lucky winner. And I'm looking forward to doing more of those. It's been fun. And a lot of positive comments on the history stuff. Man, that means a lot to me. So thank you very much for getting through all that. So this is going to be the end. Thank you very much. Next video, what do I want to do? I need to do the lowers. I need to start on those guys because I do have my coils. I got those guys right there. So I need to start on those. And if I have to modify the spring pockets, I will. Fingers crossed I won't have to. We'll see. Again, never done lowers on an Impala. This will be the first time for me. So we'll see what we get into next time. But until then, take care. Much love. Appreciate every one of you. And I look forward to seeing you next time. Peace.